What is up? It's Andy Feliciotti, and if you're new here, I'm a photographer and I also make videos. And if you're not new here, welcome back to another video. Today we're gonna be talking about Final Cut Pro. If you're trying to get into filmmaking or editing, I got some great tips for you. If you're still editing in iMovie or haven't even started editing, I really recommend starting with iMovie if you own a Mac. And if you're already using iMovie and you're hitting limitations, I definitely recommend upgrading to Final Cut Pro. It's $300, but if you're making a lot of videos, it's well worth the investment. But yeah, in this video, I'll be showing some of my favorite features of Final Cut Pro and some of my favorite editing tips. Also, at the end of the video, I'll be showing you some of the plugins I use. So yeah, let's jump right in. So yeah, my first favorite feature of Final Cut Pro is the built-in stabilization option. It's as simple as going here, checking a box, and it'll stabilize your footage after rendering it out for a little bit. I found that this works pretty great for most of my footage. Plus, you can highlight a bunch of clips and then click stabilize and it'll stabilize all of those. I have found that a lot of times on automatic, the stabilization is not that good and I switch it to inertia cam. And then you can alter how much it's stabilized with the smoothing feature. I usually put it down a little bit to make it more natural looking. Now, one of the newer features that Final Cut has added is more color options and color grading options. So yeah, it's as simple as going over to the color inspector after you selected your clip. Here you can change saturation, color, exposure. I like to add a little bit of contrast to my photos by putting the highlights up and the darks down. You can also add different types of color tweaking. So there's like color wheels, color curves. In the color wheel section, you can actually change the temperature of a clip, which is pretty helpful. Now, another little feature is speed ramping. This is great for creating a shot that goes like normal speed, then slow, and then normal speed without it like cutting to slow motion. You can make it ramp up to that slower speed. And that's as simple as using the speed controls here. And if you hit blade speed, you can see in the timeline now it says normal, so I added a blade in the beginning. Let me add a blade in the middle here. And you can actually drag your clip out and it'll transition into the speeds. And you can also alter the transition of the speed. So you'll see that this goes from super fast to slow. I find that great to use on drone shots especially, since you can like zoom onto your subject and then go back to normal speed. So the next feature I want to talk about is multicam. It took me a while to realize that this is actually how you use it, but you can put multiple clips together. I'm actually going to do it on this video to put my screen camera and my camera together. But it's as simple as highlighting two clips and then right clicking them and then selecting new multicam clip. After you do that, you'll have a new single clip and you'll kind of be like, oh, why is it just one clip? Well, if you click view on the top right, you can click camera angles. And after you have this up, you'll see both camera angles and they'll be synced up based on the audio. So as you're watching the clip, you can switch out the angle as you see fit. So this is great if you have like a gaming channel or doing a lot of tutorials like this, or an interview with two cameras even. So you can switch back and forth in live time and see how it's adding to the timeline on the bottom. And what I love about that is that if you want to go back and you want to delete a transition, you can do that. If you want to just make it a little longer, it doesn't like stack like other clips do. Now, if you just got Final Cut Pro, here's some quick tips that I use on most of my edits. First of all, I use the shortcuts B and A. So B is blade and A is select. So I quickly go around those to cut my clips up. Directly on the So that's kind of like a quick way to go in and just cut your footage up and get rid of the stuff you don't need. So if you want to instantly blade a clip anywhere you are in the timeline, just hit Command B also. So that's an even faster way to cut if you don't want to click on your footage. Also built into Final Cut Pro are improvements to the audio, and you can do this with the loudness checkbox. I usually recommend putting the uniformity higher and then the amount lower, and it'll kind of like any part that someone isn't talking loud, it'll level it out so it sounds the same to the listener. And I usually do that on all of my clips and then affect the volume separately. So then it'll bring up all the volumes together. Also, and if you're like me and spend a lot of time on your clips and you're rewatching the same area over and over, you can hit R to select a range and then you hold and click and drag. And then if you hit backslash, the one by the shift key, you can actually rewatch that clip over and over, which is extremely helpful when you're editing audio, for example, or editing one little transition. Final Cut Pro just crashed. I swear that's not normal. Also, I like to incorporate a lot of photos into my videos. So it's kind of boring to just throw a photo on the screen. You can add a transition, but there's a small little spot to add a Ken Burns effect, so it'll actually zoom in or zoom out any way you want. I think this adds a little bit of life to your photo, even though it's just a static image in your video. And you can do this clicking on the crop tool right here, and you pick crop, and you actually see the area where it says Ken Burns right here. and you can pick the start and the end of a clip. This works a lot better on landscape shots rather than portrait because it won't zoom in as much. But yeah, you can kind of see how that effect goes. Also, one last thing when editing, I found myself having a ton of events. Right now I still have a lot of events, but every time you keep your event there, it actually takes space on your hard drive. So even though it's painful to do, I really recommend right-clicking and moving the event to trash. If you're running out of space in your computer, definitely go in and look at your events and like audit which ones you want to delete. I usually keep a few around so then I can have the assets to take on to the next project. So here are some of my favorite plugins that I use for Final Cut Pro. I'll include links of all of them in the description. Some cost money, some are free. But yeah, first up is the swipe transitions. You probably can find these for free, but these are just the ones I have. It adds tons of different transitions. The popular zoom effect. This is great. I use this in the building museum video. So at the beginning, you can see the effect right here. It kind of takes a little bit to play around with the effect, but it definitely adds a little bit of extra to your footage. And you can also move the center point, which is kind of awesome. So I like move this one down to where the text is. But if you have a specific spot that you want to trigger, they can do that with this. Now the next one I believe is free, but you can definitely find a free version. This is the Ripple Tools adjustment layer. So if you're editing like 30 clips and you're doing color grading, you're doing sharpening, and you're editing different color profiles on it, it gets kind of annoying to copy and paste it to every clip. This is the best way I've found to apply it to multiple clips. So you just drag your adjustment layer over the footage and it'll actually apply that modification to all the footage below it. So you can basically color grade your whole entire video with just one adjustment layer on top. And speaking of color grading, I use this plugin called Color Finale Pro. This one actually costs money and there's a cheaper version just called Color Finale. But if you want to use LUTs on your videos, I just found that this is the easiest way to do it. And it also adds a lot more editing options for your videos. So you can see here, I'm actually using a stack of LUTs, actually from Peter McKinnon. But yeah, it's great to go download some LUTs and then you can definitely find tons of free ones. And you can apply the opacity to your clips also. I think it just adds a little bit of extra effect to your clips. Also, you can change the curves. Just overall, a great tool to add to Final Cut. So the next plugin I'm gonna talk about is a category of plugins, just title plugins. I get a lot of mine from VideoHive, but you can find tons of sites that sell titles and there's tons of free ones. But yeah, if you go to VideoHive, there's like packs of just lower thirds and titles and things like that. It's great for adding like little transitions to your videos or introducing somebody with just like a nice animation. And then my last plugin I recommend is Crunkle Pop Audio Denoise. In addition to Isotope Voice Denoise, these are two audio plugins. I don't really have a preference for either one. They're both kind of the same thing, but they make your voice just sound a little bit better and get rid of the background noise, especially the Audio Denoise one by Crunkle Pop. It is a lot easier to use than all the rest. And you can just pick a spot where you're not talking in your video and hit denoise, and it'll actually use that as the noise profile. So if your microphone's hissing like tss, you pick that spot in the audio and then it'll apply a filter over your entire audio clip and kind of improve it. I hope these tips were helpful. And if you're creating a video, feel free to share it in the comments. I'll check it out. Have fun, guys, and I appreciate you watching, and be sure to like and subscribe, and if you're not already, follow me on Instagram. My username is someguy. Yeah, bye.
Goodbye.
There's also a little bit of coffee left in here, so let's see how high I can spill it over my MacBook. That wasn't good. That wasn't good. There's coffee everywhere now. That was not a good idea. Okay. I hope you guys are happy.